So this problem wants us to find the power series for the function with a given center A and identify its interval of convergence. So this here, we're going to find the power series for f of x equaling 1 over 1 minus x squared, where a equals 0. So that means we're just going to have like an x to some power because our a is 0. And we'll talk about the other case later. But that's where we're going to start. So to begin this problem, we have to understand geometric series, because this looks like the sum of a geometric series here. And that's what we're going to talk about. So let's pull that idea in first. So a geometric series, it says the series converges when my r is less than 1. And then if it converges, it's going to converge to this value right here. And that's similar to what this looks like here. That's why that's a nice indicator that my series is going to turn out to be something like this when we're done. And that's what we're going to see. So first off, I'm going to use that idea of a geometric series. So I'm just going to start with the series that I know. And this is an n equals 0 to infinity. Now I'm starting at 0 because they're starting at 1 here. And that's why they get an a on top. I want to get a 1 on top, so I'm going to start at 0. So now setting this up, I'm just starting out with x to the n. So then that's going to be 1 plus x squared plus dot, dot, dot. And that's going to equal. And I get that 1 on top because this first term is an a naught. My a naught is 1, so that's what goes up here on top. That's that a that you've seen in that formula. Okay, and then it's going to be 1 over 1 minus x, because this x is that r, and that's what we end up with underneath here. Okay, so now having this formula and starting with this, to get the 1 over 1 minus x squared, think of this series here. Now this is just kind of opening your mind to the ideas of what we can actually do here to figure these out. If I put an x squared in here to the n, that's still going to be a 1. This is going to be an x squared plus x to the 4th plus x to the 6th plus dot dot dot. And that's going to equal 1, because that a naught is still 1. 1 minus, and my r now is x squared. So it is really just that simple. Once I can see the way to sub in x sometimes, or times it or divide it, and we'll get into more of those ideas later, but it is just coming from this geometric series here. So just kind of keep that in mind. So now we have the geometric series that actually represents the function 1 over 1 minus x squared, and that function is this. I mean, this series is this. Oops. And I simplified a little bit because I know when I have a power to a power, it's product. So I get this for my series. And this series is the series that represents 1 over 1 minus x squared. Now what we're going to do is, told us to find the series, and that was the first part. We answered it. Now we're going to see where this series converges. We want to find the interval of convergence for this now. Okay, so again, where do we go when we're thinking of the idea of interval of convergence? We go to ratio test. So rho equals the limit as n goes to infinity of x to the 2n plus 1 in there over x to the 2n. And I'm just going to rewrite this and skip a step, but hopefully you're okay with that. This is really going to be x to the 2n times x squared over, and then on the bottom we're just going to keep x to the 2n. And I kept it that way so we can see how it cancels. Okay, so then I get limit as n goes to infinity of x squared. Now remember here, the x is not a variable here. It's just a constant, because the variable I'm taking as it goes to infinity is n, and I don't see any n's there. So that simply means I'm just going to get x squared. So now this x squared has to be less than 1, which tells me if it's going to be less than 1, now think of it as being squared, it could be a negative 1/2. That's going to give me 1/4. But as soon as I get bigger than negative, or I should say smaller than negative 1 or larger than 1, it's going to be outside of this inequality I want to satisfy. So I can say this. Okay, and I hope everybody's okay with that, because if I plug in like negative 2 when I square it, that's going to be a 4, which means that's going to violate that inequality. So it's going to be between negative 1 and 1. Now we can try to plug in 1 here, but this is kind of something that's easy to see here. If I plug in a 1 in here, that's just going to be an alternating negative 1. I can do a divergence test and see that it's not going to work. I don't know if I really need you guys to go that far, especially when they're just the R here for the power series. And then if I put the positive 1 in there, that's just going to be 1 to the 2n, which we know by the divergence test that that's also going to be 1, which tells me it diverges because it's not 0. So from here, I would be okay with you saying, hey, the interval of convergence is, and notice I use parentheses for both the negative 1 and the 1 because they can't be included. So again, our two parts of our answer, there's the first part, and then the second part of the answer is down here. So we answered both parts of this question.